now. Now, as we get into the month of speculation ahead of the budget speech, one certainty is an announcement Finance Minister Nhlanhla Nene made last Friday of a 6.5 billion rand guarantee to SAA. This on condition that the carrier immediately implement a 90-day action plan, which includes the cancellation of flights to China and the alteration of an order for 10 Airbus passenger jets. The occasion was the much-anticipated announcement of SAA's long-awaited financial results for the year ending March 2014. After holding an AGM for the first time in 3 years. So where to from here? Nico Besaidenhout is the acting chief executive officer at SAA, and he joins us live on the program. It's lovely to have you. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you,
Dan. All right, so a big loss announced on Friday. How's the market responded to the news?
Yes, Len. The operating result for SAA for the year ending March 2014 was a loss of 374 million. Now, a loss is a loss. It's never acceptable, never really defendable. On the upside, though, the loss decreased from by 12% from 425 million the year before, on the back of revenue growth of 12%. So yes, it's not a positive message. The business did do a little bit better, but there's still challenges that do remain.
Yeah, I mean, we know that you've been in this acting position since November last year. One of the statements you made was that the time of planning is over and it's now implemented. This is what is now needed. So what is being implemented? How are we going to turn this around?
And look, SAA has had good strategy and multiple good strategies historically. The challenge has been that we failed to implement this good strategy. A case in point is if we look at the results for last year, the regional market and domestic market both grew and increased profitability by 17 and 10% respectively, directly as a consequence of clear implementation of strategy. On the international operations, however, where we failed to implement the strategy, SA's losses deepened. So it's sometimes more simplistic than we think. It is really just doing the job, implementing.
Yeah, I see the cost cutting is the big it's the big issue. You reported a 450 million rand cost saving. However, the minister is wanting around 1.3 billion rand
yes.
cost saving,
yes.
And that's the big thing of this 90-day plan that has to be implemented. What are you putting in place to try and save now?
Look, these cost savings are most definitely possible. So there's really 6 steps to take. The first step in terms of the 90-day action plan was really to obtain initial going concern guarantee. And there I have to be clear that a guarantee is often misinterpreted as being a bailout or the provision of funding or capital, which in fact it's simply not. SA has not received any capital from the taxpayer since 2007-08. In the interceding years between now and then, SA has obtained guarantees, it's raised funding against those guarantees. SA is responsible for servicing that debt and interest. So SA is in that context self-sufficient. However, for as long as it generates operating losses, it's not sustainable.
Yeah.
So the second step of this 90-day plan is to re-look where SA operates to. So Beijing, for example, is a route where we've operated for the last 3 years, and SA has generated losses of an excess of a billion rand on that route. So in partnership with Air China, we're restructuring how we service that destination. Air China will enter the route in May, SA will exit in April. So the connectivity between the two countries are maintained, except that the South African taxpayer is not picking up the tab.
Mm.
We're launching new operations into Abu Dhabi, which allows us to better service the Indian subcontinent, and therefore we can reduce some of our direct services into Mumbai. So these route and network changes, together with cost compression, just in the last 35 days, we've renegotiated contracts which yield savings of 71 million rand. We've renegotiated lease agreements on some of our aircraft, saving approximately 300 million rand on a full year basis. So I'm quite confident that through a step-by-step process, we can get to at least 1.3 billion rand in full year savings.
Mm.
Now, provided we get there, SA will, at an operating level, start breaking even, which makes it more sustainable. In the longer term, of course, we have to address things like the capital structure of the business. Last year alone, SA's interest bill increased by 29% to 250 million, just short of. In the current year, we're going to end up with an interest bill of 500 mil. In the year ahead, next year, 2016, we'll end up with a 750 million rand interest bill. So it's clear that we have to do something about the capital structure of the business.
Yeah, indeed. You speak about this route to Abu Dhabi now. Why are we entering into this market? Because, I mean, you look at these airlines like Emirates and the like, and they are hugely profitable airlines that are doing exceptionally well and operate very frequently from South Africa. Why are we going this route?
Look, 18 months ago, we announced a partnership with Etihad. We are existing in an existing partnership with Emirates as well. We do need to find a way to better link with some of the Middle Eastern carriers. These are massive carriers. We can't ignore them. We can't wish them away. So we have to find a way to cooperate and ultimately get better connectivity on a sustainable basis into South Africa, because that is the reason why SA exists. SA exists to connect South Africa with our key trade and tourism partners. And in this case, via Abu Dhabi, we're doing it in partnership with Etihad.
Okay, so I believe that starts on the 1st of April. So it should be interesting to see how that does. Before we let you go, let's ask you, what is Mango doing right that SAA is not doing? Because I know that you head up Mango as well. Mm. Mango have now released record results, doing unbelievably well, and I believe now even cutting rates because of the fuel price drop. What can SAA do that brings them in line with something like Mango?
Look, it would be fair to note that Mango is ultimately a simpler operation to run. I had the benefit from starting it from scratch. So there were no legacy agreements, no legacy practices in place, and the business single-mindedly focuses on cost and efficiency and productivity. So from that standpoint, the business is running well. In the case of Mango, it's had profits for 6 out of 7 full fiscals. And in the current case, in terms of its ability to reduce fares right now, consequent to the drop in fuel pricing, Mango is not hedged at all in terms of fuel pricing. So when fuel prices go up, we push our pricing up, and when it goes down, we reduce pricing immediately. Carriers like SAA and the majority of the world's network carriers, in one way or the other, participate in hedging programs. Now, in the year ending March 2014, SAA generated profits from hedging and translation gains in the order of 600 to 700 million. In the current year, it's sitting on the wrong side of hedges. So there's hedging losses coming in the order of 300 million. So its ability to reduce pricing in the very short term consequent to fuel price reductions is therefore limited. Generally, though, for all South African carriers, it's also true that the oil price decline is marginally or to a great extent offset by a weakening in the currency. So it's really just close management and different cost structures between the two airlines.
All right. So you've got until the end of, when is it, March?
24th of March is D-Day in terms of the 90-day plan, yes.
Well, we'll be watching closely, and we do hope that we see great things coming out of the national carrier. Thank you so much for joining
us.
Nico Besaidenhout is the acting CEO of SAA, talking to us about turnaround strategies that are not going to just be spoken about and planned on paper, but actually implemented in order to see this airline becoming profitable. All right. Let's